Somebody has really said, colors are integral part of human perception and life. Aren't they so beautiful? So welcome today to you all in the class of dyes, intermediates and pigments. Myself, Dr. Praveen Kodgire, I'll take you through the tour of these dyes, intermediates and pigment industries, which are an important part of the chemical industries across globe as well as in India. Prior looking into that, we'll look into basic definitions of dyes and pigments. What is the current scenario in terms of market share, kind of products which are being produced, import, export, some statistics. Then basic fundamental aspects of dyes, pigments, and later on we'll discuss the important products as a manufacturing of some dyes and pigment intermediates. So let us understand what do you mean by dyes and what do you mean by pigments. So dyes are colored, ionizing and aromatic organic compounds which shows an affinity towards the substrate to which it is being applied. It is generally applied in aqueous solutions. So dyes may be required a moderant to better the fastness of the dye on the material on which it is applied. So what is moderant, that we'll discuss in the upcoming slides. Let us look into pigments. Pigments are colored, organic or inorganic solid powders. Dyes are aromatic organic compounds, while pigments, they can be organic or inorganic solid powders. Usually they are insoluble. However, the dyes which we have seen, they are soluble or generally applied in an aqueous solution. Pigments are not affected physically or chemically in the substrate in which they are incorporated. Further, pigments can give a full range of colors, and pigments have a variety of application which includes plastics, inks and coating applications. These are some basic stuffs about dyes and pigments. More details we'll look into subsequent slides. While discussing, let us look into the current scenario before getting into more details of dyes and pigment. Dyes and dyestuff industries plays an important role in overall growth of chemical industry globally as well as nationally. Now, what for the dyes are used? Dyes are used in textile industry and fabric industry as well as garment industry as major consumption areas. Looking into the facts, the worldwide market of the textile dye stuff is about $5.7 billion US, and amongst them the Asia Pacific represents the largest share and account of 40% of global share in terms of market production, whereas India plays an important role which contributes 7% of world's global production. Dyes and intermediate consist of different type of dyes, azo dyes, acid dyes, direct dyes, dispersed dyes, so and so forth. Those details we'll discuss more in detail in the subsequent slides. And this is one of the sector which is having two broad areas. One is an organized sector which dominates 65% of the total market, whereas unorganized small scale industries that take cares about the 35% of the market. Moving on the same direction, as I mentioned, the dyes, India plays an important role. So the all type of reactive dyes, inkjet, dispers, leather dyes are produced in India, and prior India happens to be the one of the importers, but due to hardcore efforts in the particular sector and growth of the sector has improved in such a way that India is now exporter, or India exports products to USA, Turkey, Bangladesh, China, Germany, so and so forth. Here is some of the statistics. As you can see from this slide, the major portion of the dyes are major countries where India is exporting the dyes are United States, Germany, Singapore, Bangladesh, so and so forth. Whereas, as I mentioned previously, there are different grades or different types of products, direct synthetic organic dyes or synthetic organic dyes or synthetic pigments, synthetic organic reactive dyes, so and so forth. Their market share is shown in this particular graph in terms of value of the products. More details you can look into the website link which is shared here. There is another statistics which is just giving that depending on the different types of dye products, the tons per annum production capacity is given for the basic dyes, sulfur dyes, direct dyes, so and so forth, and the top export destination for the Indian dyes industries across the globe. Looking into this, you can definitely get an idea what important role Indian dye industries plays in the global arena, and that is one of the reason this particular industry plays, and the study of this particular industry makes us important to understand and get more detailed understanding about these products and operations. So looking into little more history and background, the preparation and uses of the dye stuff is the oldest form of human activities. Much before the invention of synthetic dye stuffs, natural and vegetable colors were used in India for the centuries in order to paint the fabrics or in order to use the colors on the moderns and substrates. So dye is a colored substance that has an affinity to the substrate to which it is being applied. That's what we can definitely get to know and the idea. So dyes are colored, ionizing an aromatic organic compound which we have already discussed in the previous slide. So dye stuff industry plays already, which I have mentioned, important aspects. The anarchological evidences shows that in India, phoenicia has been extensively carried out over 5,000 years. It's a kind of dyeing stuff or color pigments which were used. So that means this particular art of coloring the substances or substrates was not a recent one, but it is an ancient technique which was all aware with the ancient Indians. The dyes were obtained from, as I mentioned earlier, the dyes were obtained from animal, vegetable, all mineral origins with no or little processing. That was the era where the limited usage was there, or the requirement or stuffs, the production capacities were not so enormous like what we get today. And the first synthetic organic dye, that is manuverin, was discovered by William Henry in 1856. That was a synthetic. So far, in prior days, most of the coloring or dyeing objectives or dyeing purposes were done based on the vegetable or animal based products or from the natural origin materials. In 1856 onwards, the new invention or new things have come up and the first synthetic dye was discovered. So as I earlier mentioned, textile, carpet, garment industries are one of the major and prominent sectors where the dyes are prominently used and consumed. Some of the details we have already discussed, so I'll not get into more details of this. You can look into the previous part of the presentation. Now moving back to the chromophores and their applications. So dyes are basically aromatic compounds. They have an aryl ring that has delocalized electron system. Now these structures are said to be responsible for these delocalized electron structures or aryl ring structures, which we have also seen in the previous slide, that is the beta carotene structure, the linear pi bonds, and then the benzene rings on the either ends we have seen. So these structures are responsible for the absorption of electromagnetic radiations, which are that has a varying wavelength. So depending on the CO group, NO2 group, NH group, whatever it may be, the varying wavelengths are being absorbed based on the energy of the electron crowds associated with these functional groups presenting the substance. So it is because of this reason, chromophores do not make dyes color, rather it makes dyes proficient in their ability to absorb the radiations. So chromophores act by making energy changes in the delocalized electron cloud of the dye, and that is responsible for dyes to possess certain colors. So again, repeated, it is actually because of the reason that chromophores do not make dyes color. It is the color or the particular radiations or wavelength which has a color spectrum which is absorbed by these functional groups that makes and which can be either absorbed or reflected by them, these substances, that makes it looks like a color substance. So color modifiers like methyl or ethyl groups can actually alter color of the dye. We'll look now one of the example how a different colors can be imparted into the particular product by doing the alternation or by doing a particular chemistry variation into it. They do by altering the energy in delocalized electrons. It has been found that by addition of a particular modifier or modern group, the color variation takes place into the product. Let us look into that. For example, when there is a particular dye which is called para-rosanil, which has a red in color because of the NH chromophore present into the structure. The structure is given, it has a 3 benzene ring associated with the 3 NH2 groups, and the one of the and carbon is attached in the center. Now when we incorporate, let's say, 4 different methyl groups in the above structure, the structure will look like something like this. The original red color will get converted into this original reddish purple dye will get converted into methyl violet color by addition of the 4 methyl groups. Further, if you add more functional groups, then the purple blue dye, that is crystal violet, is obtained, and which has 6 functional groups or 6 methyl groups into its structure. Likewise, the as we mentioned, depending on the type of functional group present in the structure, they have capability to absorb certain radiations in the visible spectrum, and that gives or that imparts color to the dyes. What is chromophore means? Chromophore is a part of a molecule responsible for its color. The color arises when a molecule absorbs certain wavelength of visible light and transmits or reflects others. Chromophore is a region in the molecule where the energy differences between the two different molecular orbit falls within a range of a visible spectrum. The visible light that hits the chromophore can thus be absorbed by exciting an electron from its ground state into an excited state. So that is where the basic fundamental functioning goes, or basic physics goes behind the dyes to have a specific color. And the example is just given here just to understand and illustrate. The chemical structure of beta carotene is shown in this particular slide. The 11 conjugated double bonds that form a chromophore of molecules are highlighted in the red zone, and that's what is responsible for giving a specific color, beta carotene. There are some different types of dyes which we'll look into more detail, but from the chromophore point of view, we look into azo dyes which have the NH as a chromophore, nitro dyes which has NO2 as a chromophore, carbonyl groups will have this particular C double bond O as a chromophore. Likewise, there are the different functional groups. As we mentioned, the specific molecules which arises or which is responsible for the color into the dyes. Once they apply on the moderants or substrate, that gets the color of the dye. So now let us look into the classification of the dyes. Dyes can be classified in various ways based on origin, dyeing process, chromophores, and applications. There are different ways to classify the dyes. So based on origin, they can be natural or synthetic dyes, organic or inorganic dyes. Based on the dyeing process, acid dyes, basic dyes, direct or substantive dyes, wet dyes, reactive dyes, so and so forth. Based on the chromophores, as we discussed, as a functional groups, then anthraquinone, aryl methane, azo dyes, nitroso dyes, so and so forth. These are the different types of classification of the dyes. Based on applications, the dyes can be applied into food industries, cosmetic, drug industries, laser dyes, leather industries, solvent dyes, so and so forth. And based on the color index recognizes 26 types of dyes by chemical classification. So these are the various types of classifying the dyes. Indian industries typically has the following products or product wise classification of the Indian dyes and dyestuff industries: azo dyes, dispersed dyes, fast color base, inorganic ingrained dyes, naphthas, wet dyes, so and so forth. In the previous some of the slides might have seen the sulfur dyes, the reactive dyes market share, azo dyes, dispersed dyes, so and so forth. So these are the major type of dyes and dyestuff products which Indian industries produce. Now let's look into little more details in the subsequent slides about what does these dyes and what it involves, what are their functional abilities, so and so forth. Acid dyes are the water soluble anionic dyes and insoluble in the acid bath. Acid dyes are used for dyeing of wool, silk, nylon, acrylic fiber, paper, and leather. Basic dyes are the water soluble cationic dyes. Basic dyes are mostly amino and substituted amino compounds. Basic dyes are used for dyeing acrylic fiber, cotton, wool, paper. Direct dyes are used in neutral or slightly alkaline dye bath without addition of moderants. Direct dyes are used for dyeing cotton, wool, silk, paper, nylon, they are generally azo dyes. So direct dyes are also sometimes known as azo dyes. So and so forth. Likewise, you can get a more detailed understanding about the different type of dyes, dispersed dyes, wet dyes. Wet dyes have highly complex structures and are insoluble in water and used after reduction in alkaline liquor, which produces water-soluble alkali salt. Now, these basic features, why we have to understand these things, as I'm just discussing these details, these different features associated with makes them, or they have been derived based on the sometimes they help in terms of manufacturing or adapting a certain process steps, which subsequently we will look into later on, or they will decide different chemical processes which needs to be carried out, or as well as sometimes the gives an idea depending on the nature of the substrate, whether it is a anionic, cationic nature, whether the bonding can be formed between the inorganic or organic substances on the substrate. That makes a important field altogether in order to use or suggest a specific application for a different industry point of view. Dyes, that is reactive dyes, modern dyes, azoic dyes, sulfur dyes, and food dyes. So reactive dyes react to form covalent bond with the directly reacts with the fiber and provide excellent washing resistance. So some of the examples are given here. Modern dyes, some dyes combine with the metallic salt, that is what is called modern, which improve the fastness of the dye. So we see these days fancy clothing, different type of color structure, textures, and all the things what we get is all responsible because of the different types of dyeing products. So more details, what is a sulfur? Sulfur black dye is the most commonly used sulfur dyes. Color is produced by reacting sulfide and polysulfides with chlorinated aromatics. So it is generally used on the cotton clothes. That's why most of the times the different black t-shirts and all these things, the color and different shades what we get is because of this sulfur black dye. And of course, different food ingredients we use, there are different color products which we generally use on the different sweet products, different food ingredients, and so forth. That is again responsible, and these are the specific type of products which are used in the food dyes, are called as a food dyes. So they can be direct or modern or wet dyes and are manufactured with high purity and precaution to meet the required standards mentioned by food FDA, that is food department, or kind of say the, because some of these are organic or inorganic substances, and if you don't prepare them with utmost care and with utmost purity, they may affect the body functioning after consumption of these ingredients. More detailed understanding of the types of dyes, what we have discussed, or classification of dyes which we have discussed, is just elaborated here. I'll put some time or give you some time to look into these more details. More detailing has been given here, which will help you to gather more understanding on the acid dyes, basic dyes, direct or substantiative dyes, or modern dyes. So these features you can look into and prepare your detailed notes and detail for preparation of the topic. Likewise, wet dyes, reactive dyes, dispersed dyes, which type of products are there, or which type of fabric are suitable, what type of conditions are there, what type of very broad idea in terms of what type of processing is being basically carried out, that is elaborated in this particular slide. Next, again same way, azoic dyeing, and sulfur dyes, the more details are been given in this particular slide. Let us look into the little summarized and some method application, chemical types and all details of the classification of the dyes. Acid dyes, the principal substrates, as well as method of application, how it is applied, what type of processes are used in terms of subsequent manufacturing as well as operation, they have been enlisted in this particular table. Azoic compounds and compositions are applied on cotton, rayon, cellulose. Subsequently, fluorescent, food drug and cosmetic dyes or modern applications, oxidation dyes or base dyes, reactive dyes, solvent dyes, which we discussed in the previous slides. Some of the things are simplified or the summarized in this particular table. The chemical type just give us an idea, that is what type of raw materials are used and what type of reactions are to be carried out. Some of the examples of the manufacturing of dye stuffs we'll look into in the subsequent part of the slides. So preparation of the dyes. Generally, dyes and dye stuff intermediates are synthesized in a reactor. Once the reaction takes place, sometimes that reaction does or takes place overnight, over a couple of days, so and so, following a different stage of applications. Once the product is formed, then it is filtered, dried. A lot of unit processes and unit operations involves in that particular things. And once the final product requires different intermediates, and depending on the application or final product requirement, they can be blended with the other additives. So typically in case of dyes, the synthesis step involves the reaction such as sulfonation, oxidation, reduction, isolation, halogenation, amination, amination, dye azotization, followed by or coupled with separation by means of distillation, precipitation or crystallization. So here broadly the unit processes like sulfonation, oxidation, reduction, halogenation, amination, example, etc. are given, and the broadly applied or used unit operations like distillation, precipitation, crystallization are being used in the manufacturing of the dye stuff products. Dye is then separated from the mixture and purified. On completion of the manufacturing of the actual color finishing operation, including drying, grinding and standardization, because at the stages of precipitation there are lumps of, or crystallization, there are lumps of the final products are obtained, which subsequently needs to be properly transported or sold into the market. For that point of view, we need to go for the size reduction applications where the powders or the fine coarser particles are produced. Of course, the importance is to be given to maintain the product quality. So in case of dyes intermediates, the process steps covers sulfonation, oxidation, reduction, isolation, filtration, followed by drying. So by and large, these are the important stages of unit processes and unit operations which takes place in the manufacturing of the dyes or preparation. So here a detailed snapshot of that stepwise manufacturing is illustrated here. What are the operation sequences involved in the dye manufacturing and operation sequence involved in the dyes intermediate manufacturers. You get raw materials, the chemical synthesis takes place. As chemical synthesis means different type of, depending on the functional groups requirement or depending on the raw materials involved, whether you have to go for different type of dyes, acid, base or different type of things, or different type of chemical functionalities, the chemical reaction is carried out as we discussed in the previous slide. The followed by filtration or isolation, reacted, unreacted byproducts are being separated out. The respective products are dried, grinded or pulverized. blending is done if required, because if that itself is a final product, then blending is done, packaging is done, and the dye products is ready for the market application or for the final application. But certain stages are more specific when you talk about dye intermediates, because these intermediates can be going into different stages of operations and then they go into the final dye application. So raw materials may be sulfonation, filtration, followed by centrifugation and further oxidation, reduction. Sometimes you can skip the depend on type of application which is required or type of final product. The oxidation step can be skipped off and it can directly go to the reduction and further size reduction, then it can be filtered out or separated, isolated, further filtration. Likewise, these are the different dye intermediate manufacturing steps or sequences goes for the manufacturing point of view. Now we'll look into the various dye intermediates and their structures. So benzene based dye intermediates and their structures, and here there are four columns are given. Products are benzene, their derivatives, structure, method of preparation, and their application or purpose. 4-aminobenzene, that is nothing but sulfonic acid, which has benzene ring. One end is SO3H group, another end is a NH2 group. The sulfanilic acid is a gray crystalline solid produced from the sulfonation of the aniline. So aniline is sulfonated to produce this particular sulfonic acid. It is used to make the dyes and the sulfur drugs. So it has a pharma application. Or another product comes under this category is NN dimethyl aniline or DMA, which has benzene ring and NCH3, whereas two methyl groups are present in pendant carbon group. So initially it was prepared by heating aniline and iodomethane, and industrially it was produced by alkylation of aniline with methanol in the presence of acid catalyst. These are the very brief description of the manufacturing process is just elaborated here. So the derivative of aniline DMA is a key precursor to commercially important triaryl methane dyes such as malachite green or crystal violet. So if you have to get the type of colors for the particular application point of view, these malachite green or crystal violet colors for that point of view, these products are obtained or these products are used. So let's look into a couple of other products. Gamma acid. Now gamma acid belongs to a class of hydroxyl naphthalene aminosulfonic acid, is a key intermediate used as diazo and coupling component for the manufacturing of commercial dyes, which belongs to the class of direct acid, acid moderant and reactive dyes. So what we are discussing is one is the dyes, that is a final product, or dye intermediates. So this particular compound which is given here or known as gamma acid, it acts as a intermediate, dye intermediate, which can be then coupled or mixed with different compounds to get the final product as a direct dyes, acid modern dyes or reactive dyes. So let us look into a quick manufacturing process. G-salt is subjected to the particular reaction in presence of liquid ammonia or liquor ammonia, in presence of sodium bisulfite in aqueous solution under the presence of autoclave. That means that is a relatively high temperature process which converts this G salt in presence of this aqueous ammonia, in presence of this NHSO3 or sodium bisulfite, will produce a amido G salt, which then subjected to alkali fusion with excess of caustic soda or in presence of caustic soda flakes, which then further neutralized with 40% of so this sulfuric acid to and then isolated to the gamma acid. So this is the final product of gamma acid. So the G salt, aqueous ammonia in presence of sodium bisulfite gives you the amido G salt, a water rich byproduct release. Then it goes for the further alkali fusion in presence of excess of caustic soda flakes, and then in order to recover or get rid of the unreacted NOH, it is neutralized with 40% of sulfuric acid, and you do the isolate, separate the gamma acid, and sodium sulfate solution is additionally produced as a product. We have seen here which has an important application in the formation or preparation of dispersed dyes, solvent dyes or acid dyes. So we'll quickly look into mercury is heated in 20% of cullium at 80 degrees Celsius for 3 hours. Then anthraquinone, which we have just discussed earlier, is heated. Of course, these are the two separate substances heated at different conditions. One is mercury in oleum at 80 degree, anthraquinone at 130 degree Celsius, and we carry out the sulfonation reaction. Then this particular product is filtered, neutralized with ammonia, and after cooling at 30 degree Celsius, precipitate out to get or to give you anthraquinone 1 sulfonic acid ammonium salt. Typical reaction scheme is given for mercury for anthraquinone at 133 degree Celsius. This is at 80 degree Celsius for 3 hours. This HgSO4 is produced, and then that particularly responsible to get the anthraquinone 1 sulfonic acid ammonium salt. Here the ammonia is reacted, what are the acid. This is another step what we discussed previously to get the anthraquinone 1 sulfonic acid. This is another method you can think about, and there we reacted with NaOH. Here we are reacting with ammonia, so the H is replaced or H is added, sorry, NHC is added along with this SO3H groups to get the anthraquinone 1 sulfonic acid ammonium salt. Likewise, resorcinol, you can see particular process. And another important aspect is, important activity which you have to do is study the major differences in dyes and pigments. Study the one main or important study the main reactions, at least one of the products which falls in the different category of the different type of dyes: azo dye, basic dyes, modern dyes, wet dyes, sulfur dyes, so on and so forth. I hope this makes you more comfortable in terms of understanding of this particular topic. If you have specific query, you can get back to me through email or through our interaction group. Thank you.